गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास. इन दिस सेशन ऑफ बिजनेस एनवायरनमेंट वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग फ्यू ऑफ द टॉपिक्स लाइक इंट्रोडक्शन टू FDI, FII, पब्लिक प्राइवेट जॉइंट स्मॉल स्केल सेक्टर, ट्रेंड्स इन वर्ल्ड ट्रेड, फॉरेन ट्रेड एंड इकोनॉमिक ग्रोथ, GATT, WTO, UNCTAD एंड वर्ल्ड बैंक एंड IMF. So starting with the first topic, that is FDI and FII. Basically these are the investment protocols, basically with the help of which investors invest in different countries. FDI is basically a long term investment in which the fixed capital is being created by long term fixed investment, like setting up of businesses, subsidiaries, plant, machinery, those investments which will create a long term asset in the country are regarded as FDI. The permission for this kind of investment is given by the government of the respective country. While when we talk about FII, then it is a investment in the assets like the stock market of the particular country. When foreigners tries to invest in the stock market, purchasing shares of the companies, then that is regarded as the FII, foreign institutional investments. These investments are not just limited to the stock market itself. These are extended towards the other areas also, like the commodities market, currency market, and various other platforms where assets are being traded. Then comes public, private, and joint sector. As we all know, public sector is where the ownership of the business lies with the government. Therefore, government companies are called public enterprises. Private companies are where the ownership is with private individuals. So that is private sector. Joint sector is where the ownership is jointly held by public and private based on the ownership pattern. Trend in world trade. It is very important to understand that in recent years there has been a certain shift in the world trade pattern, and the reasons for this kind of shift is forced dynamism. Dynamism means, as we all know, the societies are growing. As with the growth in the society, we have seen from the 18th century, the trade has created a boundaryless markets. Businesses have expanded beyond their domestic boundaries. Therefore, when we talk about the trends in world trade, then change is very important factor, and that has prompted towards the expansion of businesses through dynamic approach. Then comes cooperation among countries. As we all know, every country is dependent for resources and markets among each other. Therefore, it is with the help of this trade that cooperation have increased and resources have been shared among countries, so that the growth should be evenly distributed across the globe. Then liberalization is also one of the factors, that opening up of sectors for the private investment, foreign investment by the governments, have also been the reason for the growth of the world trade. Then transfer of technology is very important, because technology is one of the driver of modern businesses, and when technologies are being transferred from one country to another, one area to the another, then every area gets benefit of it. Therefore, trade usually expands in such a scenario. Emerging markets, as we all know, the developing countries have been the engines of growth from the past several years, and that is the reason for increase in the international trade. Then comes foreign trade and economic growth. As we all know, foreign trade is very important, and economic growth is dependent on foreign trade, because foreign trade helps in increasing the movement of goods and services, import and export, movement of technology, resources, the ideas, the methods, and that is very important for long term prosperity of the global community. Then comes the international regulatory authorities like GATT and WTO. GATT was the organization which was created before WTO. It was an organization which was created for promoting the international trade by reducing or eliminating trade barriers. Basically, it was a promotional institution, but it doesn't have any kind of rules and regulations. Like it doesn't have any body to take care of disputes, resolve the dispute. Therefore, it came into end, and a new institution, WTO, was emerged. WTO was considered as a significant international trade regulatory authority, under which 123 nations have signed, and GATT was replaced. Now the WTO is very broad organization, which not only promotes international trade, but it also has the action taking authority also, which keeps a proper overview on all the trade activities, and if anybody violates terms and conditions, then they have the disciplinary body who can take actions against the countries in international tribunals. Next comes UNCTAD. UNCTAD is another part of United Nations. It is a United Nations organization's part. That means it is a organization which is UN related. Therefore, the goal is maximize trade, investment, and development opportunities. But it is an organization which is created to support the growth in developing countries by resolving their issues, problems on equitable basis. Because as we all know, the developed countries always gets the advantage, but developing countries are always left. Therefore, UNCTAD was created in order to raise the issues or problems, or to help the developing countries. Now coming the World Bank and IMF. As we all know, after World War II, the Bretton Woods conference was held, in which one of the important decisions related with the international organizations like World Bank and IMF was created. World Bank is an international financial institution that provide loans and grants to the governments of low and middle income countries. Therefore, the objective of World Bank is to provide financial assistance, while IBRD is an institution that works under World Bank. The objective of IBRD is to provide the financial assistance to those countries who have lost economic assets or the destruction due to the war. So after World War II, the countries got huge losses, or their economies was destroyed. To recover their economies, IBRD was created to provide financial assistance under World Bank. Then comes International Monetary Fund. Basically, International Monetary Fund is an organization that works under World Bank. It provides the various resources, like financial resources, with the help of World Bank to those countries who require those resources for their growth and development. Therefore, International Monetary Fund is a very important organization. It keeps an eye on the emerging issues and problems of the countries, thereby providing solutions to those countries. And therefore, when we talk about all these kind of issues, when we talk about the international organizations which are created to resolve the issues in the international trade and investment, then we have to take it in a broad aspect. Like, if WTO and IMF are created, then their objectives are entirely different, because their function is different. WTO is basically a regulatory authority. As we all know, every game has certain rules, and in trade also there has to be certain rules, so that the interest of all the parties should be protected. Therefore, WTO keeps an eye and create these kind of rules and regulations, and also at the same time protects the country's interest and the parties were associated with the trade and investment activities. Therefore, every institution is considered as important in the international scenario, and world trade is not possible without the cooperation and without the coordination of these institutions. Therefore, whether it is a World Bank, it is IMF, it is IBRD, or it is GATT, all these institutions have had a history of improving the terms, improving the policies, improving the conditions for the world trade. And now I would like to thank you for this session. Have a nice day.